Hi, I'm Danny from the MITRE ATT&CK team, here to introduce you to the ATT&CK framework. ATT&CK is a knowledge base of adversary tactics, techniques, and case studies for machine learning systems based on real-world observations, demonstrations from ML red teams and security groups, and the state of the possible from academic research. We built ATT&CK with our colleagues at Microsoft and from the feedback and submissions from many other companies and academic institutions. ATT&CK enables security researchers to navigate the landscape of threats to machine learning systems. Our goal is to raise awareness about the risks of deploying machine learning models, create a common framework for documenting and organizing adversary behaviors, and build a community of machine learning and security experts. You're looking at the homepage of the ATT&CK website, which is live at atlas.mitre.org. ATT&CK is modeled after the MITRE ATT&CK framework, and its tactics and techniques are complementary to those in ATT&CK. If you know ATT&CK, the ATT&CK machine learning matrix you see here may look familiar. Machine learning models have a novel ATT&CK surface that pose a new challenge for security analysts, and thus we have new tactics and techniques particular to ML-based systems. The column headers are tactics which represent the adversary's goal or the why behind their actions at a particular point in an ATT&CK. For example, over the course of an operation, the adversary may perform reconnaissance to learn about the victim machine learning model, acquire some level of access to the model, and use this to have some impact on the system. For each tactic, there are several techniques that document how the adversary will achieve their tactical goal. For example, if an adversary wants to gain initial access to a network, they may accomplish this by compromising the ML supply chain. There are sub-techniques that enumerate the potentially vulnerable parts of the supply chain. The ATT&CK matrix only lists tactics and techniques relevant to machine learning. In practice, machine learning models don't live in isolation. They may be part of some larger enterprise network. Let's jump over to the navigator. We've imported ATT&CK as a platform in the ATT&CK navigator. Here you can see the ATT&CK techniques in green alongside ATT&CK enterprise techniques. When machine learning is used in the enterprise setting, adversaries may use a combination of traditional cyber techniques and ATT&CK techniques to achieve their goals. The navigator is a powerful tool for browsing ATT&CK and ATT&CK side by side, performing analysis, and building visualizations. For example, we can highlight techniques according to their frequency in case studies to better understand likely threats to our ML. Here, the darker red boxes indicate that the technique was used more frequently. Now back to the main website. The matrix view provides a good overview, but we might want more detailed information about a particular tactic or technique. We can click on any of these tactics or techniques to learn more. For example, if we want to learn more about one of the new tactics, ML model access, we can click and be presented with a description of the tactic. In ML model access, the adversary may attempt to gain some access to a machine learning model. This is a key tactical goal in many ATT&CKs. It can help the adversary gain information, develop ATT&CKs, and as a means to input data to the model. Each tactics page provides a description of the tactic, a listing of techniques an adversary may use for the tactic, and the case studies that the tactic is used in. We'll get more into case studies in a moment, but first, let's take a look at the main techniques page. Again, techniques are how the adversary achieves a goal or what they gain. On the techniques page, we have a searchable list of all techniques. We can browse them by expanding any of the tactics, or we could also use a keyword search. Let's look at the evade ML model to learn more. Model evasion describes how adversaries can use adversarial examples to prevent detection by a machine learning model. This technique may be used in the defense evasion or the impact tactics, depending on the adversary's tactical goal. We can also see that the evade ML model is used in many of the case studies that we've collected. Now, let's move on to the case studies page. Each case study documents an ATT&CK on a production system. We found it important to ground ATT&CK in techniques observed in the real world and shown to be effective in practice. We collected 13 case studies that show a broad range of adversary behaviors, varied use of techniques, and several different tactical goals. The case studies are really at the core of ATT&CK. They helped us design the matrix-based feasible ATT&CKs. We added tactics for the new tactical goals we observed and broke up techniques into behaviors aligned with those goals. Each case study walks us through the step-by-step procedure the attacker used to carry out an ATT&CK. Let's do a deeper dive into one of these. If we select the case study Bypassing Silences AI Malware Detection, we can see a summary, some additional information, and the procedure that the red team in this case used to carry out the attack. In this case study, researchers at Skylight were able to create a universal bypass string that, when appended to a malicious file, evades detection by Cylance's AI malware detector. The procedure is a step-by-step walkthrough of the attack. In this case, the red team used reconnaissance to learn more about the victim model. They gained access to the AI-enabled software. They developed their capabilities by probing this software. They created adversarial examples manually, and ultimately used them to evade detection by the malware detector. This is a great example of how using ML in security software increases the attack surface and opens up the system to new ML-based techniques. Finally, I want to share how you too can contribute to Atlas. Atlas is a community effort. Please send us any feedback or suggestions to atlas@mitre.org. Also, consider submitting a case study for inclusion on the website. Case studies can come from your internal red teaming efforts or observations of adversary behavior you've observed on your network. Thank you to everyone who has already made major contributions to Atlas. We hope that you will find Atlas to be a useful tool to learn about ML techniques and adversary behaviors, build threat intelligence reports, share case studies from your own red teaming exercises, or assess the defense posture of your deployed machine learning, among other things. Thanks for listening.